It's the very lovely Geordie on Barcelona City FM with her current offering, Heaven I Know. Good morning. How are you doing? This is Jim Kent. Well, talking of one lovely lady, I've got one in the studio with me this morning. A very big good morning to Lauren. Lauren, good morning.
Hi.
How are you doing? Jim.
Good, good. Thank you.
Now, I know that you've literally just flown in.
Yeah, just arrived.
So where were you before coming to Barcelona?
It was 12 hours in Rome.
12 hours in Rome. What did you do in 12 hours in Rome?
Oh my God, we walked around and we just grabbed shots of the city. It's amazing.
It is an amazing city, isn't it?
Yeah, as Barcelona, amazing too.
Yeah, not bad, is it?
Oh, love it.
So this is your jet set tour of like the Mediterranean cool cities.
Yeah, exactly.
Fantastic. Now, I know that you're also known as LaluRight.
Yes.
Where does that name come from?
I think it's from young, Lalu was sort of my nickname, and that just is how it evolved. And I travel between LA and Luxembourg, so it works there too.
Between LA and Luxembourg.
Yes.
Now, not too many people can say that, probably.
Right.
So I can kind of guess what the draw to LA was, but how did you end up in Luxembourg?
I was born there. Born and raised in Luxembourg.
Born and bred.
Yes, exactly. So very cute little country. But I'm actually British American, so very, very diverse.
Absolutely. Hard to beat that. Now, what about musical background? Have you kind of always been a musical person?
Yeah, I'd say so. I mean, it's something that sort of evolved in my childhood. My mother used to throw amazing events, and we'd have a lot of artists come along, so musicians, painters, you know, a lot of amazing people. And that really got me.
Now, what about playing instruments?
Playing instruments. We had a piano around when I was younger, so we'd just sort of play around with that. But I was really, really attracted to the guitar, so started that at a young age, and then just sort of made music.
Wow, fantastic. Well done. Hey, now, I understand that you've got your first track is out already, isn't it? What's it called?
Yeah, Naked.
Oof, that's quite a brave name for your first track.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, I'm putting my emotions out there. So it's sort of like if you were naked in front of people you didn't know. Mm. So,
Emperor's New Clothes and all that. And so when did you write this song?
I wrote this when I took a gap year, and because I didn't really know what I wanted to do with my life. And so I went to LA, and it was back there, I was feeling a lot of nostalgia, I guess, at one point in the beginning. And this song sort of, it just created itself.
Wow. So ladies and gentlemen, we're delighted to play right now. Barcelona City FM, you're listening to LaluRight. This is Naked.
This house naked, waiting for your phone call, baby. I walk around this house but naked, wondering when you want to come and touch me, touch me, kiss me, kiss me, feel me with your hands, grave me, grave me. Squeeze me, squeeze me tightly in your arms. Oh, oh. Feeling your breath on my skin is a whole new awakening. What was I thinking when I left you to linger in silence? I don't know. Clearly I didn't want to let you go. Lately.
That's the fantastic LaluRight on Barcelona City FM. And I've got the lady herself here with me in the studio. Good morning. How are you doing?
Hi. Good, good.
I love that song.
Ah, good. I'm happy you do.
It is quite emotional, though, isn't it? It's quite a tearjerker.
Yeah. I mean, it's very personal, we could say. Yeah.
Sure. So have you had many situations when you did stand up in front of people and you thought, oh my gosh, I feel naked right now?
Yeah, I mean, playing this song in front of people, I feel naked.
I'm sure. Hey, so tell us a little bit more about, so you're doing lots of different things at the moment, aren't you? So you're kind of working on fashion and you're studying entrepreneurship. How are all these different kind of component parts fitting together?
They just all work together. It's so weird. Fashion and music is just like both things that just work. I did a lot of fashion when I was younger, and I met amazing people whilst doing that. And so that sort of gave me these amazing contacts to work on and work with.
So what kind of fashion were you doing?
I was doing a lot of catwalks because of my height.
Uh-huh.
But that was really cool.
Yeah, I think you're taller than me. Are you 1.78 meters? Yes, yeah, I'm 1 meter. Yeah. I can't believe that. Never date a woman who's taller than you, because it makes you feel very insecure.
No, that's so not true. So I was able to travel with that. And traveling for me gives me a lot of inspiration. And so I think that really helped me just figure out things for myself and see that this world is huge and it's beautiful. And then it also helped me fund all of this, all of my music, basically.
Okay. And then you decided to go and study over in London. That's a very dynamic choice. Why London?
London's like, for me, it's amazing. The artists that come from there, the possibilities, the opportunities, the city itself, I love it. London.
And which college are you studying in?
Goldsmith.
Okay, which is quite prestigious.
Yeah, it's a cool arts school, basically. And so I'm studying business there, entrepreneurship and management. But I want to study that in an arty environment. So I chose Goldsmith, and I love it. It's really cool.
Often when you're entering this world of kind of fashion and music, in a way, it's you that has to become the brand.
Yeah.
How easy or difficult are you finding it selling yourself?
For me, it's quite difficult because I think it's something you have to get used to capturing things where I just like living it. That's one aspect of it that I find sort of hard. And also, who am I? I'm still discovering who I am. And through my music, I'm able to also discover myself. So it's very hard to go, I am this person right now, because I feel like it's something that evolves over time and it changes, which is great. I think that's beautiful. So, yeah, those two aspects really get me nervous, we should say.
Now, I've got another song ready to go called Hello World. Where did the idea for this song come from?
So this is a special song. I went to Africa and got some back vocals because my dad's he grew up in South Africa. And so we do a lot of trips when I was younger, back and forth in between different places in, Kenya, South Africa, and a little island called Lamu. And so they speak Swahili, and the language is just amazing. And Africa itself is just, I mean, it's so creative. And so I really wanted to create a song that would capture that.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, here we are. It's our first play on Barcelona City FM. Here it is. It's Hello World.
Jungle anyway.
Now, we just got the short version of it here, but people are going to want more of this. Is that available yet?
No.
Oh.
No.
Oh, my goodness.
Nobody's heard it yet.
Wow, ladies and gentlemen, that's exciting. So what's your plan, musically speaking? So we've got one full track out, and you've got another one on the way, correct?
Yeah. Got a song called One Day on the Way. So that works well.
It does.
Yeah. One Day on the Way. So that should come out in September.
Okay.
And then afterwards, probably bring out an album.
Yeah.
And then afterwards, Hello World.
Okay.
It's more of a summer song.
Fantastic.
And then, you know, we'll see.
But then we'll see. So where are you doing the production for all your songs?
In London.
Okay.
EC1 Studios. It's a really cool friend of mine named Brando, who's helping me out with these songs. And we're just jamming in the studio and just creating beautiful things.
Wow, awesome. So it sounds like you're having a brilliant time.
Yeah, I'm really enjoying it.
Okay, sure. We're going to come up with your track One Day in just a few minutes' time. Stay right with us. You're listening to Barcelona City FM 107.3. Barcelona City FM. I've been joined by the very lovely LaluRight here in the studio. Now, Lalu, we're almost out of time for this particular segment, but let's just dream a little bit about the future, what it might hold for you. Have you got any particular sort of musical fantasies, anywhere that you'd like to play or perform, for example?
Oh, wow. Yeah, of course. I think anywhere for me is just amazing. When I was in Rome, you two were playing in the near the Colosseum. That's really cool.
Yeah,
isn't that?
That's a good aspiration to start with.
No, but I'm happy playing anywhere as long as I get to play. Really, it's all beautiful.
Okay.
And fun.
Yeah.
For me. Yeah.
Hey, so when you do perform, are you playing the guitar as well as singing normally?
Yeah.
Okay.
I prefer, but then some songs. You sort of want to get into it more vocally, so I'll let the guitar out and have some friends of mine play along.
Okay.
But yeah, it's sort of the way we do it.
Brilliant. And can you imagine yourself getting basically solo artist, so you're going to become this singer-songwriter type, or do you reckon it'll grow? Could you form a band around yourself? What do you think?
Both sound amazing. I mean, I don't have a preference. I'm really just sort of figuring out and see where it will go. But I used to have a band in high school. But then, you know, you also go your own way, but I still meet up with them and we jam and we that's good fun. So definitely having a band is a nice way of doing it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, you seem to have done a lot of traveling. You've managed to fill in a lot of cities and countries.
Right.
Anywhere next on your list that you'd like to go and visit that you've not been to yet?
I'd like to go all around the world, if possible. But I'm going to Peru soon.
Going to Peru?
Yes.
Yeah. Awesome. What's taking you there?
I just love traveling and seeing the scenery, and it really inspires me and helps me write music. So, I mean, Peru has a lot of historical value to it.
Sure.
And so I'm just going to check that out and see the beauty of the country, really.
Absolutely. Now we're going to finish off today's show with the third song in your collection that you have right now. It's called One Day. Where did this song come from?
This song is just from my gap year. I was traveling around and I took a gap year to figure out what I wanted to do with my life.
And did you figure it out, or are you still figuring it out?
I have an idea now.
Oh, good.
Which is good. And that song sort of describes that.
Brilliant. Hey, well, LaluRight, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Have a great time in your remaining few hours here in Barcelona. Thanks for fitting us into your kind of packed schedule.
No, I'm happy to come. I love it.
Go and catch some sun. You're listening to Barcelona City FM, your English-speaking station here in Catalonia.
Crazy love.
And if you want to contact our artist from today, LaluRight, find her on Facebook or Instagram at the same name. That's LaluRight, LaluRight. Gotcha.